Alright guys, today I'm going to take a quick look at this really fun but very basic and very, very tough shooter for the Master System. This is Astro, where it was developed and published by Sega in 1986, and besides being on the Master System here, they also put it on the arcade for their Megatech hardware, so it's also on that. This is far from the most unique or original shooter out there, or even for the Master System, but it's a very solid one. It's really fun. Again, yes, it is very hard, but it's a decent challenge, and it's got a lot going for it, and really it's actually kind of impressive for the Master System, which I'll get back to that. There is one thing, though, easily the biggest problem with it, which isn't so great, and I never really like it when shooters do this, but I'll come back to that. It's something I've talked about before with some other shooters I've even done videos on, and say, like, for example, Blazing Lasers. Anyway, the story with this isn't that unique or original either, but it goes like this. The game pits you against a fleet of superpowered spaceships, referring to the bosses there, and ultimately the invincible Master Ship. And in this treacherous black universe, you can only count on yourself. Man, is that true. Of course, as always, you die in one hit when you get crashed into a shot. That's standard. You don't have any continues. You only have the one, I guess, if you count it like that. You only have a few lives once you burn for those. That's it, and then you have to start all over. But you might as well start the entire game over anyway, because, as I mentioned, this is the biggest problem with it. It shares the same problem with a lot of shooters, again, using Blazing Lasers as an example here. If you die once, basically, and you have a lot of upgrades, you might as well just reset the entire game, because there's no way you'll get them all back in time, and you're too slow and weak to basically survive against the bosses. It's just not possible. You can't move fast enough to avoid their shots. It's unfortunate, but it's not enough to ruin the game. It is basically the biggest sticking point of the game. Outside of that, it's fantastic. Anyway, let's get to it. Also, there's a thing, like some other games do, like Super Fun to Play, where it doesn't feel like the need to show you your score as you're playing, because, you know, why would I ever want to see that, right? I don't know. But the game's got a lot going for it. As I said, it is fairly impressive on the system. It's got a lot of enemy variety, it's got some really cool music, plays well, doesn't suffer from really any kind of slowdown. I've played this a lot, I like it a lot, but I'm not great at it, foreshadowing. But I've never really noticed any kind of slowdown of any type, especially sprite flicker. Never seen a sprite flicker in this game. I don't know how they did it, but they pulled it off. It's impressive. All the stuff going on screen, lots of sprites, fairly detailed sprites at that, and nothing really slows down or flickers much. Other Master System games, other shooters on it couldn't even handle that. I like this one a lot, as I said, and I do play it quite a lot, but it's not my favorite shooter on the system. That still probably has to go to a list day. Which, that's another thing for another day, but obviously that's a older game in the same series that Musha's part of. Actually goes back to the SG-1000 for that. Anyway, yeah. This is definitely one I highly recommend checking out for the Master System. It is very difficult, but it's not unfair. The only unfair-ish part to it is that thing, like I said, where it punches you for dying. Now here's another thing. It's kind of more an observation. It's an odd thing, but it happens. Even when you're used to it, it can still happen. Because everything's constantly coming at you, you need to shoot constantly in order to survive, you can accidentally easily miss upgrades, or sometimes mistake them for an enemy and skirt around them so you don't crash and die. I've done that so many times, and I still do. But the hardest ones by far are those little purple balls which you just saw me collect. They're options. They're very important in this, more than some other games, trust me on that. But they're so easy to miss because they're so small. And especially those little purple ball flashing enemies, they blend right in with them because they're the same color. So you gotta really be careful with that. They're easy to miss. They might move slow, but they can get off the screen quick. Overall, it's got one kind of major flaw, really, but the rest of the game is fantastic. Not very long, of course, as most shooters like this aren't, but hey. It's got some pretty cool bosses in the big. This first one isn't that difficult at all, really. Zanoni, which when I first played this, I mistakenly thought it said Zamboni, you know, that ice scraping machine. And there you go, that was quick. That's an example of why the options are so important in this. Sometimes it goes a little faster, sometimes a little longer, but it's... Well, when you're fully upgraded your weapon and you also have the options, both of them, you're near unstoppable, kind of. Except for your ship is made of paper mache, so you die in one hit, of course. This is when I usually start failing, the second stage here. Now, I'm gonna try my best, guys, but I'm gonna try and get to the boss without losing all my stuff. Can't guarantee on that. This is a very hard game to play while talking. It really is. But, going back to that, to me at least always, I think that's pretty much the main reason why we play shooters, in general. Because, let's be honest, the story in these is always crap. There might be a few exceptions, but for the most part, it's not interesting at all, it's not even that original. But, it's the gameplay. It's all about the gameplay in these, and I've always fought and have said that a good shooter should actually be pretty difficult. Not brutally unfairly hard, but it should have a bite. And this does. It is all about practice. And, you know, concentrating and not talking while doing it. But it's still. It's got a lot going for it. It really does, for the Master System. If you like shooters, you've never really played much on the Master System, I say this might be a good place to start. Or if you are familiar with it and you just didn't know about many shooters in the system, you want another one you never played or even heard of, look into this one. It's fantastic. I love it. Even with its few faults. And I don't really mind resetting the entire game over. I mean, dude, this is not the first attempt I've had making the video. I'll tell you that right now. But, it is what it is. I played far more unfair shooters. Trust me on that one. Really more unfair. This is just hard. Which is also something a little strange, at least to me personally. There's other shooters I could play very well that are hard, but this one, there's some I can't, even though there's others I could play that are hard. Yeah, it's just one of those things, I guess. That's why we like games like the Darius series, R-Type, Gradius or Nemesis, whatever you want to call it, Salamander. And then you got standalone ones like this. I think they deserved the sequel, really. They could have made a sequel for it on the Genesis Mega Drive, but they never did. Alright, so here's the boss I usually never can beat, Nebrios. You can only kill him by shooting him in the middle. Yes, you can destroy his turrets, as you just saw me do, but, ooh, that was close. I could have got hit there. Oh, I moved right into his shot. That was bad. Now, here's a perfect example of what I meant by you pretty much can't beat the bosses when you're like this. You move too slow. You cannot dodge their shots. It's not possible. Unless you just happen to make absolutely, extremely accurate movements. Ooh, I don't know how I missed that one. Oh, I was doing okay. Let's try it again. I have a few more tries. Really, really like the music on this. It does remind me of another shooter, only on the NES. I did a video of it, actually, long ago. I can't remember the name right now. Especially since I'm trying to do this. Whoa, boy. This I need to get over. I need to take out his... Yeah, there you go. That works. Now I can start working on trying to kill him. I cannot even begin to explain how hard this is. When you lose everything, it's just forget it. There's nothing you can do, pretty much. I need to take out his turrets first, then I can start to kill him. The funny thing is, the bosses really don't require that many shots at that point to kill. Even at this point. Whoa, yeah. Okay. Now... oh, wow. Oh, I got it. There you go. I didn't think I was going to be able to pull it off. I'm not happy that I lost everything. I'm really not, because it's just not good, but hey, I burned through a few lives there, but hey, I made it. There you go. Well, at least I can show you more now. Yeah, this is... See, I'm moving so slow, it might as well be like I'm in syrup. Hopefully some upgrades appear soon. Which they usually do, not long from now. That is a good thing, though. You do get quite a lot of stuff that gets thrown at you for upgrades, and there's one right there. Which, luckily, the first one is speed. Ooh, I thought I was gonna beef it right there. But here's another example of just the enemy variety in this game. Even in the same stages, they still throw new enemies at you constantly. And I screwed up there. Oh. This is another example where having options is very helpful. I'm trying to take these guys out, but I can't really move fast enough to get in front of them. The one time you do want to get in front of an enemy. Alright. Last attempt here. Let's see what I can pull off. If anything, I just make my score higher. Because we all know how much I like doing that. I like these enemies. They kind of are strange, but I like them. Most enemies of this are pretty much geometric patterns anyway. Oh, there was another upgrade there, but it wouldn't have done me much good, I think. Oh well, it's hard. It's a really hard game, but it's a really good one. And it was also my final score, which is pretty high. Anyway, but there you go. That's it. Astro Warrior for the Master System. It's a hard game, yes, but you know what? It's a fantastic shooter for the system. It really is, and it's a ton of fun. It really is. I highly recommend checking it out. Anyway, that's it, and I will see you later.